friends, welcome to my channel. So in the today's lecture, we are going to discuss various attributes. Okay, we are going to discuss various attributes we will be using in the entity relationship model. So I told you that before actual implementation of the project, firstly we make ER diagram. Okay, it is very important to visualize your project in the form of graphical representation, okay, so that you can improve the speed of your project. Before actually implementing the project, what we are doing, firstly we are going to design the database. Okay, we are going to design the database. So in the last video we discussed the various kind of entities are going to be used in the entity relationship model. In this video we are going to discuss various kind of attributes that we will be using in the entity relationship model. So the first attribute we have is key attribute. So what is the meaning of key attribute? Key attribute is the attribute which is going to be helpful for uniquely identify each and every record of the table. What I mean to say, I have a table in my database and I have various number of records present in the table. So key uniquely identify, to differentiate each and every row from one another, we just need to have a key attribute. Okay, so let me give you one example, like we are residents of India. Okay, so to uniquely identify each of us, what we are given? We are given a Aadhaar card. Okay, so within a country, we have to differentiate one person with others. So what we are given? We are given a Aadhaar card. Let's suppose if I have name Aarti. Okay, so there might be many number of girls having the same name. Okay, so that is the reason that we are given a Aadhaar card, so that we can differentiate each and every individual. Okay, so similarly in our table we have a many number of records. Okay, to uniquely identify each and every record, we are given a key attribute. Like in a class, okay, in a class we have a roll number as a key attribute. Okay, so to uniquely identify each and every student of class, we are giving roll number. So roll number is a key attribute. Any attribute which is going to be helpful for uniquely identify each and every record, you can call that attribute as a key attribute. Okay, so what are the various examples you can take in the key attribute, like email ID. Okay, each person is going to have a different email ID. No two persons can have the same email ID. So you can also consider email ID as a key attribute. Okay, so what is the symbol we really use for key attribute? So the symbol which we use for key attribute is like this. Okay, you can write here as a ID. So this is actually the symbol which we use for key attribute in the ER diagrams. Okay, so now let me discuss the second attribute. We have a simple attribute. simple attribute. What is the simple attribute? Simple attribute, any attribute which is just having only one value. Okay, any attribute having only one value. For example, name. Okay, name is a simple attribute. We are having only one value for the name. Second example could be date of birth. So we can have only one date of birth. One person is having only one date of birth. So you can call these examples as the simple attributes. So you can call name and date of birth as the simple attributes. And what is the symbol we use for simple attribute is this. Okay, like name. This is actually the symbol we use for the simple attribute. The next attribute I am taking is multi-valued attribute. Okay, multi-valued attribute. Okay, so any attribute which is having many values. Okay, let me give you one example. For example, phone number. Or you can also take the example of email ID. Okay, these two you can take the example of multi-valued attribute. One person can have more than one phone number. One person can have more than one email ID. Okay, so these are actually your multi-valued attribute. Any attribute having more than one value called as multi-valued attribute. And what is the symbol we use for multi-valued attribute? This symbol, phone number. Okay, so this symbol we actually use for the multi-valued attribute. Okay, all these attributes which I am telling you we are going to use when we will be making the ER diagrams. All these attributes are going to be used, okay, in ER diagrams. Next attribute we are taking is composite attribute. Okay, composite attribute. Let me give you the example. Any attribute which can be divided further. Okay, for example, name. Okay, name is an attribute. It can be divided further into many number of sub attributes. For example, what is your first name? What is your middle name? And what is your last name? Okay, so name is actually your composite attribute. You can call name as a composite attribute because it can be divided further into many number of sub attributes. What can be the some other example of composite attribute? Address. You can take address as the example of the composite attribute. So what is your street number? What is your city? Pin code. What is the pin code? Okay. So you can also consider address as the composite attribute. So this is the symbol we use for the composite attribute. This symbol we use for the composite attribute. So the next attribute we have is derived attribute. Next attribute we have is derived attribute. What is the meaning of derived attribute? Let's suppose you are given a date of birth. Okay? You are given date of birth. So, you don't need to mention age. You don't need to use the age attribute when you have the date of birth attribute. Okay? What you can do? You can derive age from the date of birth attribute. With the help of some calculation, we can determine value of age from the date of birth. So, what you can say? So, age is actually your derived attribute. Age is actually your derived attribute. You are deriving it from some other attribute. Okay? So, what is the symbol we are going to use? Like this. This dashed. Okay? This way. You can use this symbol for the derived attribute. Okay? Age is our derived attribute. So, these five attributes which we discussed are really going to be used in the ER diagram. So, if you have any query, I have mentioned my email ID in the description box. You can contact me on that email ID. So, thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel.